This is the one-of-a-kind carbon fiber Titan submersible, missing in the dark waters of the North Atlantic, with five people on board since Sunday.
There could have been an accident. It could have become entangled in the wreckage of Titanic. It could indeed have had a catastrophic failure. The answer is we don't know just yet.
Contact with the sub was lost nearly 2 hours into its dive to the Titanic, 700 kilometres south of the coast of Newfoundland in Canada.
It is a challenge to conduct a search in that remote area.
Crews scouring both the surface and waters nearly 13,000 feet deep.
There aren't many submersibles that are capable of going to these depths. It's harder to go to that depth than it is to go to the moon.
The sub is just 7 metres long and typically carries 96 hours of emergency oxygen.
This is essentially a leisure craft. It'll have some spare air and some in compressed bottles, which will enable it to do an emergency surfacing, but it'll only last for so long.
Tourists pay almost $400,000 to OceanGate Expeditions for this. The chance to see the world's most famous shipwreck up close.
The once-in-a-lifetime opportunity to be a specially trained crew member safely diving to the Titanic wreckage site.
Feared missing, a British billionaire, the founder of OceanGate itself, a French explorer and a Pakistani father and son. The search is as complex as it is vast.
The seabed is very undulating. Titanic herself lies in a trench. There's lots of debris around, so trying to differentiate with sonar in particular is going to be very difficult indeed.
And with their oxygen supply dwindling by the hour, it's a race against time.
CBS reporter David Pogue travelled in the Titan submersible last year. David, you've actually been on this vessel. What was it like and why were you on it?
I'm a TV journalist here in the States, and I was invited to do a story about this remarkable company, OceanGate, that was taking tourists down to see the Titanic for $250,000 a person. So it was a cameraman and a producer and me. And it was a real adventure, which is the whole point. The submersible itself is it's a cylinder about the size of a minivan. And it has titanium dome end caps on either end to seal you in. No chairs, no benches. You're just sitting on a flat floor with your back against the curved wall.
From your knowledge and experience of it, can you offer any insight as to how this particular vessel now may have become lost? I mean, it's obviously an enormous area that it's traversing.
Well, they weren't even on the sea floor yet when they lost contact with the ship up above. There is no GPS underwater. There's no regular radio. So the submersible driver has to operate based on short text messages from the ship on the surface. And there are pings every 15 minutes that the sub makes that say, I'm here. But an hour and 45 minutes into the dive, both of those signals stopped. So that could mean that the power was gone, or it could mean a catastrophic implosion of the submersible. Both are very, very bad. If it was a power issue, maybe they're at this moment floating on the surface, because one thing I did admire about this submersible is there are six or seven different ways to get back to the surface. I mean, there's various forms of ballast that they can let go. There are propellers that can push up. There's an airbag they can inflate. So there are many ways to get to the surface, even if the power goes out.
So even if that is the case, there's obviously a lot of risks involved in the whole thing. Did they talk you through what the risks are?
Yes, they make it very clear. This is, they say right up front, this is not for tourists. This is for adventurers and risk takers. You do sign a waiver that outlines, no kidding, 10 different ways that you could get killed. You might get killed on the ship. You might get killed getting into the sub and so on. So you are well aware of the risks.
And how did you feel about all of that?
I honestly did not sleep a wink the night before what was to be our dive. I just thought, this is a completely unknown for me. On the other hand, intellectually, I told myself they've been operating for 3 summers, and each summer they go out for 5 of these week-long expeditions, and they've never had an accident, never had a death or even an injury.
So do you think it's all worth it to see the Titanic?
The dive that I was to make to the Titanic was aborted after only 37 feet down. Then they had a mechanical problem and they returned to the surface. they take you for 5 days at a time to the Titanic. So in theory, the paying customers have five chances to get down to see it. The people who did make it down, they say it was worth every penny. They say it was life-changing.
So, David, based on everything you know, how hopeful are you of a positive outcome?
I mean, if the sub is still underwater, I would say the odds are very low. Even if we could find them underwater, which is almost impossible, how do we get them out? You can't open the hatch under the sea. The pressure would kill you. And there are only perhaps three submersibles in the world that can go to 2.4 miles down Titanic depth. And they are all much like this submersible, which is to say, very small, very low power. You are not going to tow this submersible back to the surface with one of these other submersibles, even if you could get one mobilized in time. It takes weeks to put one of these expeditions together. So I'm not sure how we would get them out, even if we found them. So my best hope is that they're on the surface, alive, and we just need to find them.
Let's hope so. David Pogue, thanks so much for joining us.
My pleasure. Yeah.